Hey, welcome back to Tam Talk. I'm Tam, your host. Today we're continuing the 30 days of video games with day 4, your guilty pleasure game. Oh yeah. Now, I'm going to be trying to make these episodes just a little bit shorter so that we can get through the whole 30 days before, like, 2015. Heh. But this one was kind of a no-brainer, and it's got to be Bayonetta on the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. This is the kind of game where no one in the pre-order line could look each other in the eye. We all saw the same trailer of Not Dante wearing a fetish suit made of hair, doing cartwheels for days, and taking her clothes off to summon enormous demons. It's a guy gamer's masturbatory fantasy made flesh. I mean, you know, sort of. And wrapped in so much fetish gear, it's a wonder she doesn't have a special move that involves a ball gag. Unless she does. Wait, does she? No, I think I would have remembered something like that. Moving on. The combat is fast and satisfying, with a move-canceling dodge that means if you have good enough reflexes, you can beat the game without getting hit. You're rewarded for doing particularly well with increasingly glittery trophies for each rank. Presumably the best of them is just a jewel-encrusted butt plug. The revealing special moves from the trailer are present and are fun to watch and satisfying to pull off, even if they give you a wrist cramp. You know, from tapping the button so much. It's the same kind of fast-action whoop-ass we love about the Devil May Cry series, but Bayonetta was made by Sega instead of Capcom. The first thing this means is that we have no hope of seeing her make an appearance in Marvel vs. Capcom, which makes me want to throw myself off a bridge. The second thing is that the game is chock-full of Sega references, which is awesome. Everything from the rings you collect being modeled after the ones in Sonic, to Bayonetta using the Henshin Agogo line from the Beautiful Joe series. The music is fun and jazzy, with a particularly nice version of Fly Me to the Moon on repeat for more levels than I care to admit. The bosses, especially the final one, are huge and insane on a Gurren Lagann level, and for beating the game, you're rewarded with a bonus menu that has a video of Bayonetta dancing that might as well be labeled fapping material. Actually, the funniest thing about this game is that my wife's super Mormon mom bought it for me. I wonder if she even looked at the cover art before she gift-wrapped it. Haha! Awkward. There's a sequel planned, Bayonetta 2, which is going to be a Wii U exclusive, which means that the Wii U just jumped to the top of my must-buy list, just above the Virtual Boy and the N-Gage. Honorable mentions for this question is Bulletstorm. I love games that invest time in spectacle and color, but while the team was busy making the game beautiful, the script was left to be written by the special needs intern. The script is so embarrassingly bad that I have to wait until everyone else leaves the house before I play it, so I don't offend anyone's sensibilities. It's ridiculous, they use the F-bomb like commas. The shame is that the game really is fun to play, with a very creative score system that gives you points based on how creatively you kill your enemies. Maybe we'll get a sequel that isn't completely retarded.
So there you have it, my guilty pleasure game. Remember to leave your answers in the comments below. Join us next time for day 5, the video game character you feel you're most like or would want to be like. And make sure to hit that subscribe button and maybe leave me a like. See you next time.